Okay, so maybe as well that business today I'm going to see how do you stretch a hyperbola and so how do you put it on the Cartesian. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, to sketch a hyperbola, you need basically four things. You need the vertex, you need the two foci, you need the radiuses, and you also need the asymptotes. Now, reduce on the size of the video, then the working, then I'm just going to explain, then I sketch as you follow. Now, you see, this one is going in the negative, you see that it's on Y, meaning it's going to cut the horizontal axis, hence it's going to be a transverse axis. So, if you compare A squared and this, you start your A is this, this one is the same as 1 squared, your B, compare it to there, you have that, that your A is 1, your B is that. Now, because it's having a horizontal transverse axis, then it's the formula we used to get there. Simplicity. Your b squared is a as 4, your a squared is a as 1. You substitute. When you see now, when I take this side, this one is going to be now 5, the square root, that's what I get. The vertex is ever at hk, so that our h is 1, our k is this. I substitute there. The two foci, this is the formula we used to get them. When I substitute them, you know that my a is 1. I use e, which is root 5 here. I get this, if you simplify, you give two decimal places, this is what I have. The directrices, this is the formula for the two directrices. H is 1, then a over root this. When you simplify this to two decimal places, one decimal place, this is what we have. The directrices of this form are given like this, so that our k is 2. Then b over a, because the axis is going to be horizontal transverse axis. Then x minus 8, which is there. When you open, now when I take the positive, I have 2 plus 2 into this. Then here I have 2 minus 2 into this. When you open the brackets, I have 2x, then minus 2. Then minus 2 is going to cancel this half on red, 2x. Then when I have here, come here, this is negative 2x. Then negative by negative, you get positive 2 plus this 2. That's when you have a 4. Now, you know that this one is a standard line, it's passive to be coordinate, so you don't need to. When I come to this one, I need to get its intercepts. So when x is 0, I put here 0, y is 4. And when y is 0, I put here 0. I'll be having 2x equal to 4, divided by 2, your x will be 2. You have those two asymptotes. Now, the sketch is, we scan on our vertex, you will see that it's going to be a horizontal transverse axis. So I start by sketching this k, where it is going to be 2. So, hyperbola is going to, where the vertex is going to sit on the horizontal. So I'm going to do 2. Like that. So after drawing there, I start from the start, this one is going to be 1, 2, 1, 2, so my vertex is going to be here. My vertex B, which is 1, 2. Then I have the other, now I come to the two, for kind of one, the first is then 3.2, somewhere, 2, this is my first focus. 3.2, 2. Then I have my the other has -1.2, 2. -1.2 somewhere, 2. This is my second focus, which is 2. 1.2, 2. Then I have my directrices as x equal to 1.4. 1.4 is somewhere here. So you press 1.4 there. Then you draw a line there, dotted. This is my x equal to 1.4, and then x equal to 0.5. x equal to 0.5 is going to be somewhere there. So you draw it there, 0.5. See, this one was small. So this is my x equaling to 0.6. So after that, then we come to these two assumptions. Y equaling to 2, so that when x is 1, y is 2. So by the way, all of them pass through. Then x is square. When x is 0, it is 0. So you need 2 points. When x is 0, y is 0. So it passes there, so that this one is already passing for the origin. And then when x is 1, y is 2. y1 is 2. So here and here, then I draw that asymptote. Of course, the asymptote passes through the brackets. So this is my y equaling to 2, x. Then I come to this one, 0, 4 is here. Then 2, 0, it's there. Of course, it's that it's going to pass through that point. 1, 2. There, like this. So, it passes through the bottom, the vertex. Remember that already. The two asymptotes, they pass through the vertex. All the two asymptotes pass through the vertex already. This is y equaling to -2x + 4. Now I start plotting that. And then again, now I start the sketch. Now you see my vertex, I mean my curve has its vertex there. Means it's going, this is, it's asymptote, it's going to come to graze the asymptote like that, then it goes like that. But the question is, how far does it go from the vertex? On the x, it goes 1 unit. So if this is 1 here, this is 1 also. It's 1, so I add 1 unit in the end, so I have 2 it here. So it's going to cross it there. Then from here, I also count 1. From the vertex, I count 1, it's going to cross it there. Why? Because on the horizontal, we always count A units. So that's why from the vertex, I count A to get where that curve is going to cut the horizontal axis. From here, I count A. Then I count A units. Going inside 1, 1. Why? Because A is 1. If it was 2, I count from the vertex 1, 2. Then inside also 1, 2. Okay, so meaning, going to come, it grazes these two asymptotes, crosses there, then it grazes this asymptote again, like that. Then this side, it comes, it grazes, remember it has to pass there, it grazes that asymptote, like that, then goes this side like this. Now, you see where they are going to intersect with down now 2 units from the vertex. It's going this one, so they are going to be at 2 units. From here, I count 2 units. So there, you see, there, that's where our is going to form that simple box there. So, members, that is the first sketch, and this one we call it a hyperbola with transverse axis and horizontal transverse axis. When I come to this, should I read you and sketch it? Okay, anyway, let me help you a little bit. See this one, this vertex is at 0, 0, so it's going to be here. Now, you see, if I had maybe 1, I would draw a 1 because it's now vertical, so I'm just doing 1, but it's not there. Anyway, 0, 0, then I have my 2 foci at 0, 9. 0, 9, which is this side, and the other at 0, negative 9. Negative 9, then this one is 0, 9. Then the other one, I have it as, you see this one is passing through the origin. When x is 0, y is 0. When x is 1, y is a half. So it's going to be towards the other side so much. So I like this, this one with a negative slope, it's going to be like that. Of course, y values are small, but x experience and being. That's why extending so much through the x-axis. Even this one, the same case. So this is my y equal to x over 2, and this is my y equal to x over 2. Everything here, I think you can follow how we got the eccentricity, how we got the everything is very expanded there. Now, if we come to the differences, we have y equal to 1.8. 1.8 is near here. Get your ruler, draw it there. Now you see it's y, that's why I'm drawing our horizontal, because that's where it's going to cut that line, it's going for it's cut the x axis. Then y 1.8 is somewhere there, you draw it there. So this is my y equal to negative 1.8, y equal to 1.8. Okay, so now our arm is going to turn like this. Now the question is, how is it going to be bending? Now, from the vertex, that is on the B, we have 4 units. So from the vertex, I count 4 units. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's going to cut it there. Then also down, I count 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because B is 4. Then this side, I don't know, because I just need a B because the line is starting in there. So now if I'm sketch, I'm going to sketch like this. To raise the starting point like this. Then this one has it there, come there, then I engage there. Then the vertices, you see, the aside from here, you just count 2 units. So 1, 2. So 2 are falling off there. That we are going to be having it there. The 2 there this side, the 2 is here. On the why am I counting 2? Because from the vertex I count, you know where it's going to make that box. So from here 1, 2, so I draw there. Then inside 1, 2, I draw so up like this. Then the 2 this side, 1, 2. It's going to cut it there. There down. I count 1, 2, 1, 2. So that is the box that we are going to form there. But anyway, that's a simple, that's how we draw those two hyperboles. So I wish you the best. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you in the next lesson.